Now let's get into the calculations relating to the leasing. Now that we have understood the basic assumptions associated with the project, let's try to do some kind of basic calculations associated with the leasing aspect. Right, we have a few assumptions dealing with the leasing aspects. We have the land area, market value of the land, annual lease rental, increment in the lease rental, and the lease deposit. These five things are contributing to the leasing related assumption. So we'll try to create what is the annual lease and what are the expenses the company is incurring as far as the lease rentals and the lease deposits are concerned. All these things will take up. But before we do any kind of detailed calculations, some of the things I would prefer to be there as a part of the model is, okay, pull out your year number. See, as I said, everything needs to be dynamic. In this case, I know that my project is for 33 years, wherein 2 years is a construction period and 31 years is an operations period. So I have to reflect the same. So every sheet, probably let it contain this particular information which talks about the year number, and let these years be dynamic. When I say dynamic, let them be created based on the total number of years of construction as well as operations. How do I do that? Initially, probably I may start with a 1. I will start with a 1. But what I will do is, from the next year onwards, I will check if this particular year, the year which is in the previous cell, is less than the sum of these two, the construction as well as operations. I'll put a dollar there. If the current year is, or if the year before that is lesser than the summation of these 2 years put together, I will increment this by 1. I will increment this by 1, otherwise I will put a blank. What is this resulting in? If we see it, this is becoming 2. And now when I tried, this is a kind of a beauty you can create with your formula. Probably you maintain that, okay, you will do this up to a z number of years, maintain some consistency in the column. As long as I am talking about AZ, I will maintain it. But this is showing 33 only as far as the years are concerned, and after that it is showing me a blank. The reason being, our formula is very comfortably applicable only as long as the years are less than the number of years. This is the kind of consistency we have to bring in into the formula. Just for example, instead of the 31, or probably instead of 2 years of construction, I'm talking about 4 years. So the total duration should be 35 years. And when I come here, I should see that my time period that is shown is 35 now instead of 33. That is how the model can become more and more robust for us, right? And yes, one more thing here. Here, when I am writing, I am not writing 2 years here, right? Probably if I had written 2 years, and if I have written 31 years, if I had done the summation of these two, this is actually resulting in an error for me, or zero for me. Whereas when I do the summation of these two, It's actually showing 33. Why is it so? The difference is the way you have written these things. Here I have not written 31 years at all. I have only written 31 and gone into the format of this particular cell. Whatever is the text that needs to be replaced, what I do is I get into this custom formats and I create my own format. If I say, let it be in terms of numbers, what I'll simply do is I'll put a hash and I'll put a zero, and in the space I will put years within the quotes. So means it's a number followed by a text called years. So automatically this gives me 31 years. Same way I have written all these things, 150 lakhs per acre. Just to say, I don't want 150 lakhs per acre, I want to convert this into crores, so I want to write 1.5. But this is still showing me lakhs per acre. So what I will do, I will go into format cells. Instead of lakhs per acre, I will put crores per acre. I'll just change it as crores per acre, and now you see this is showing me 2 crores, but it's better that I have it as 1.5 crores. So instead of having a number format like this, probably I may put 0.00 form, means 2 decimals after, 2 numbers after the decimal point. So this becomes 1.5 crores per acre. So this is a better way to represent your numbers, so that they look much better. This is more of a formatting issue and nothing to do with our calculations there, right? Okay, so going back here, it is showing the numbers, the year numbers are getting dynamically updated. The moment your input values or input assumptions are getting changed. And one more thing I require in this case, okay, now that I know the years, I also need to know the phase of each one of them. Probably these two lines, I would maintain it consistently for all my sheets, right? So the phase, the first 2 years is the construction phase, and after that it's the operations phase for me. So the same thing has to be reflected as a part of my formula. All I will write is, if this year number is less than or equal to the construction period, right? If the current year number is less than or equal to the total construction number of years, write it as a construction phase, or probably put a C there. If it is not, write it as an operations phase. But okay, when I am doing this, what is it that is coming out? This phase will be written as construction phase. And remember always that you drag this up to AZ exactly. So that, but what is reflected here is, even after 33, it is being shown as operations phase itself. That is creating something wrong in our formula. So what we can do is, on the top of this calculation, I will always maintain this particular construct. If the above one is blank, leave it as blank. Otherwise, only do this entire calculation. I will do this, and now when I drag it out, you will see, make sure that up to a certain point you drag all the formulas so that that consistency comes up, right? And if you are seeing it only up to year 33, I am seeing it as operation space, and the first 2 years are being shown as construction. Just as a quick verification, change the construction period to 4 years and operations period to 35 years. Let me come back here. The first 4 years is being shown as construction phase, and probably the total number of years is being shown as 39, and up to 39th year we are seeing the operation space itself. If this has to be presented in a better way, probably let there be a centering in the format except for the first one. So the C and O, right? So that is something that we can bring consistency into our model. So I am again going back with the original numbers, and what I could still see is this is something that is updated only for a 33-year period. Now, the actual calculations part. As far as the leasing is concerned, we know that we have two major components in it. One is the annual lease rental. Correct? Let me highlight that. There is an annual lease rental. Then lease deposit, and probably total lease expense for the year. These are the three things I'm more concerned of as far as the leasing is concerned. So all these three, they are applicable both for my construction phase as well as operations phase. So from that standpoint, my only verification will be, as long as this is not blank, fill this appropriate columns. But the once this turns blank, make these also blank, right? That's one rule. Then how am I computing my annual lease rental? At least for the first year, I can look at it as the land area, or probably the lease rental, annual lease rental is 1.2% of the market value. What is the market value? 1.5 crores per acre multiplied by 55 acres. That is what is my annual lease rental. But of course, this lease rental has to increase by 5% every year. So what I can do is, first thing I can do as, if the year number equal to 1, if the year number equal to 1, which means for the first year, I will take it as it is. And if it is not equal to 1, any other year, if the year number equal to 1, I will do that. And if the year number is not equal to 1, I can multiply the previous year's annual lease rental into 1 plus the lease growth. I'll multiply it into 1 plus the percentage increase in the lease rental. Okay, now let's see. For the first year, the lease rental is 0.99, whereas for the second year, it grows. And probably when I drag it along, it is showing me some numbers even beyond 33. And as a practice, I always suggest that you drag up to AZ. So it is showing me some number, because that constant consistency in the rule needs to exist. If the above is blank, this rule, please don't forget. If this is blank, make this as blank. Otherwise, do this entire calculation. Now you could easily update, and even when you have dragged it until here, what you will clearly observe is the lease rentals are updated only up to the 33-year period itself. Now the lease deposit, the same way, we are saying 50% of the lease rental. So first we'll do the calculation, then we'll put the rules. So this number multiplied by 50% F4. So this needs to be my lease deposit. But of course, again the same logic of if the first one is blank, leave is as blank is very much required. So probably before I drag it, I will do that exercise. If this is blank, leave it as blank, else do this entire exercise. So when I am dragging this across up to AZ, this is what is coming out. So this is what is working out as the lease deposit. And now when we are talking about, so coming to the total lease expense, what we are looking at, it should be the lease rental as well as the lease deposit. But the only thing we have to be comfortable with is the lease deposit will be only the delta amount, right? Initially, if I have already deposited 0.495 crores and for the second year the requirement of the deposit is 0.51.52 crores, probably all these things, what we can also do is we can do a better formatting of them in the form of two decimals. Probably we can do the formatting of these cells in terms of number with two decimals, right? So at least 0.5 crores is being deposited as a lease deposit, my total expense in the second year, if 0.52 crores is required, probably if I deposit extra 0.02 crores, that would be sufficient, right? So that is where in the first year, probably I may have to deposit both of them. So that's where I'll write a rule. If the year number is equal to 1, I would do the addition of these two. Otherwise, I would just do the addition of these two. Otherwise, I would do the addition of these two minus the previous year's value, right? But in this case, okay, let's try out. For the first year, it is coming out to 1.485 crores, then 1.06. Yeah, this is the delta. So it is coming out to those numbers. Probably we can drag this off. And here, this is where it is giving me a hash value error. Whereas until the last or the last before year, these are until the 33rd year, some kind of numbers are getting represented. Now, how do I address that situation? First, let's try to do the formatting properly, right? I'm setting it to two decimals. Then what I could very well write is, if the top, if the first year is blank, I will maintain it as blank, otherwise I'll do this. Okay, so these are some of the things. And at the same time, there is one more rule for us which we have missed out, that if it is the last year, right, if it is the first year, we have simply added, otherwise we have said this. But before doing all this, I could have even gone ahead saying if this is the last year. So how do I know if this is the last year? I can write one more rule on the top of that. Right, if this is 1, do this. Otherwise, in the fault block, I can write one more rule saying, if this is equal to the summation of these 2 years, which will say that this is the last year. If this is equal to the summation of these 2 years, then you refund back the lease deposit that has been done till date. So, which means it will involve the current annual lease amount minus the lease deposit that has been done till date. So, it is more like it will be the current lease rental minus whatever is the leasing deposit that has been done till date. That should be taken care into the model. Alright. So, these are the multiple rules that are present in our model. So, let's try to drag this to see if we were able to replicate that aspect. So, you see here in the final year, suddenly there is a 2.36 that is getting refunded back to us, which is resulting in our total expense being only this much. So, these are our total lease expenses over the life of the project. So, if I am looking at probably the total, we can even find out the total annual rental, working out to the summation of this fourth row, this much annual average annual rental, average annual rental, working out to the formula called average on the top of this. So, these are the typical numbers for our various calculations. So, this is how we build our rentals, lease kind of an agreement. So, probably this number at a later date will go into our P&L statement. This will go as a part of our balance sheet, whereas this might go as a part of our cash flow statement. So, these are some of the things that we have to really look at, because total lease amount that is going away from our pockets, total cash that is going from our pockets are these numbers. These are the various cash flows for us. So, probably assuming a 10%, assuming a 10% interest rate, I can even find out what is the present value of the various cash flows that are being incurred for us. So, if I am looking at that number, it is saying that the present value is to the extent of around 16.23 crores at the rate of 10% per year. That's the present value of the entire lease expenses that are getting incurred over this entire period. The summation of them is going to close to 79 crores. But if I am taking the present value of that, it is only around 16 crores at the rate of 10% per year. So, this is what we have to do as a part of our lease space modeling. Right? We'll likewise next we will get into the construction calculations, then into the operations, then finally use this entire information to building our P&L statement, balance sheet and the cash flow statement. Alright. But we have to make sure that any of these numbers changing, it is getting reflected into our leasing calculations quite comfortably. Probably if I am saying yes, the lease rates are growing at 7% instead of 5%, all these numbers have to be automatically updated. That part has to be taken care of on a quite comfortable note. So at every sheet which we are going to prepare, the first two lines will remain the same, and probably the consistency with respect to the columns also from B to AZ is the time period which I am typically modeling, the year 1 to year X. So all these things need to be consistently maintained, and depending on the various rules we are using to build this model, the robustness of the model will finally come out. All right. Then let's move on to our next set of calculations, which are the construction based calculations.